futile. Your life, as it has been, is over.
I'm MJ Fred Michelle Lynn Johnson. I'm from Toronto, Canada, and I've been on the Vision train since March. I was fortunate enough to do Amanda Sage's painting retreat at Punta Mona in Costa Rica at the beginning of February, and then I went to Envision Festival where I vend my clothing company, The Fairy's Pajamas. Since COVID began and the train's gone up, I've become a full-time painter again, and I feel like I've gotten back to my true art, my true passion. And I have never felt so aligned and transformed into the most of myself that I've ever had in the last 6 months. This is my mushroom painting. We did a 2-month celebration where the theme was mushrooms, and I'd been painting some fairy mushroom homes on my trip four, DJ Fairy on Thursday's trip four. I sometimes make these drawings. Here's another one. They're with watercolor pencil crayons and black ink. And here is the one that transformed into my mushroom painting. I'm actually not finished this painting. I haven't worked in all of the watercolor yet. But here it is here. I've also included the train. Oopsie. And I've used a lot of symbols. This painting is called They Must Have Eaten Mushrooms. I've needed an ego boost of late, and so instead of painting the good and the bad, I thought I'd paint the assisted and the assistee. Just trying to find balance within all of this chaos happening. And painting is the way for me. I really appreciate everybody, and I want everyone to know that there is no answer. The only thing that we can do is to stay positive no matter what. And I think if everyone did some mushrooms, they would feel like that too.
Hi, I'm Lacey Valandry of Silver Arrow Art, and I'm super excited to present my new painting, Santa Mycelia, and it's featuring this goddess woman who is the connection between all of the trees and everything, and I wanted to include mushrooms that I've found throughout this foraging season so far. So there's some pheasantback mushrooms, there's some chicken of the forest, some oyster mushrooms, morels, turkey tails, and whatever mushroom was sitting in my front yard the other day. I'm super excited about this project. It's with the Vision Train, the Mushroom Painting Challenge. We started it a few months ago now, and this is going to be our first collaborative show together, so I'm really excited.
My name is Raymond, and I'm the artist of that board you see behind you called Symbiophilia. I made this board as part of a challenge and a fundraiser for the Queenstown Happiness House, which is a community support center. Our country has been hit especially hard after COVID, so the idea was to fundraise as much money as possible to help everyone who is struggling right now. What I was trying to do here was incorporate three things, which are the Tree of Life, the Fruit of Knowledge, and Chaos Camp, the Serpent. And as we all know, in this example especially, the Fruit of Knowledge is mushrooms. My intention for this piece was just to bring to light an alternate story and rendition of the classic Bible story we hear, and maybe give a different perspective on what could have actually happened. So the medium is a snowboard. I did an enamel base and then painted over with acrylics, and I've got also some metallic gold, silver, bronze in there, so if you hit the light right, it shines a bit. And yeah, the overall color scheme I would call bubblegum. I'm selling this snowboard for $420 because, if you didn't know, in New Zealand, in September, we're having a referendum for the legalization of marijuana. So $420, thought it was appropriate just to spread some awareness. We really need some help down here. If you could get active online and help out the cause, you'll be doing our country a favor. That's all from me. Hope to see you all on the Vision Train. Let's jump aboard. Choo-choo! Peace, love, unity, and respect. Aho!
Eileen Rose, also known as Rosie. I'm so happy to be part of this exhibit because I think mushrooms are so amazing in so many ways. They're beneficial for your immune system, and they're beneficial for your memory and the soil, and can take you wonderful places. So I'm so inspired. I'm also a mandala teacher and a sacred geometer. So many of my paintings start with a sacred geometric grid. And in this case, this main piece that I'm putting in the exhibit, it started with this grid, and I went into meditation, and then I saw the images I wanted to include in it. It was done in the Miche technique, which I learned from my beloved friend and mentor, Amanda Sage, and it really changed my life when it comes to painting. It upped my game. This painting was also done starting with a geometric grid. But this one's done on a Prismacolor pencil on pastel paper, very much similar to the Miche technique, in which I use glazes of pencil. And these three pieces were done a little differently. They use a technique called decalcomania, where you create a crazy background using splashes and drips. You can take cellophane and squish it up and stamp with it. And it's almost like looking into clouds and you start to see images, or in curtains you see faces. You start to see images come out from the designs in the background. So these started like that, and then I started to add other images. There's lots of little hidden things here, like dung beetles and gnomes. And these three paintings have light sensitive paint, so some special areas glow in the dark. So blessings to all. And remember in the words of Bob Ross, every day is a good day when you paint. Namaste. It's a gorgeous day here on Long Island, so I decided to paint outside here before I eat dinner. Working on my journey to the center of the mandala. It's got a lot of mushrooms and eyes becoming aware. And it's a good day to work on it as we celebrate the decriminalization of visionary mushrooms in Colorado. So what I'm doing on the outside now, I'm adding a little mycelium web, lots of little interconnective strings, and that'll be covered over with a wash of color.
Hello, my name is Stefan, and this is my painting that I like to call the Willy Tree. So this painting was created during the first month of quarantine, and also during that time was the beginning and the start of the vision train. And there's not so many words that I have for this painting because it was largely improvised and without any direct intention, but the story that came through this improvised time of being isolated and being together is that there is this bubble of isolation, this place of safety, and this place of cultivation. And here, I like to think of it kind of like the network. The mycelium network is referenced in this, of course, as it is somewhat of a mushroom, but also the rooted connection to the earth and the tendency to download information from the earth is shown here. It's almost like this is the spaceship, or this is me during this time, and this is what has been harvested from this time, and collectively created with the vision train and all the community members and the Academy of Visionary Art crew and all of us being able to come together in this time of separation. Thank you.
Chugga, 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 chugga.
This is the morale of the story. Yes, it's a true story. And it happened right here in this very yard. It's also my first oil painting and my first attempt at oil glazing.
Why not? All my materials had come at that point for me to just dive in. And I did my first oil glaze and it was so fun. I was like, oh, this is why they do it. This is fun. I'm liking this a lot. So,
my name is Chelsea Steyer, and I have been working as a physical therapist assistant for the last 20 plus years. However, I have engaged in artistic and creative pursuits since I was 5 years old. When making my art, I like to communicate with spirits and guides to help me, since I am a self-taught artist and the guides help with all kinds of stuff. My goal is to infuse my art with higher energy and light, so that the viewer can remember or experience this energy and possibly experience other dimensions or realities. What led me to want to do this was something that happened in 1994. I fell asleep and I had a dream, but this was a dream that was much more than a dream. I experienced my death, then I interacted with my guide, and then I was taken to another dimension. This completely changed my life as well as my outlook on life. Since then, it has been my mission and goal to communicate this experience as well as other experiences that I have had. So that my hope is that it helps others see that there's more to life and that you are loved and supported by an unseen world. Thank you very much.
Hi, I'm Lauren Blair. As you can see, I like to paint. This piece right here is one I am doing for a class with Amanda Sage, who I have taken a class with at the Chapel of Sacred Mirrors a couple of years ago. I really enjoy learning about art and painting. and it has expanded my repertoire. Even as I have been painting for most of my adult life and even my childhood, and have taken classes and have gotten a good degree. Even more than that, I feel like I have learned more from my association with the artists that I have met at the Chapel of Sacred Mirrors, especially the teachers, but also the other students with whom I have been very much inspired. And I feel that my art has really expanded dramatically since about 2010, when I started taking classes at the Chapel of Sacred Mirrors. And I feel like you never can stop learning. You always can learn more. And I am really looking forward to more work that I can do outside of class and in class. And I really love you guys, and hope to see some of you very soon.
Hi, my name is Miles Seiden, and this is my piece, Beyond the Veil. As you can see, it's an illustration of a family of mushrooms under the shade of their favorite tree. The personification of the mushroom in the foreground just kind of emerged as I was working on this. I first did it as a pencil drawing after a long hiatus from doing artwork, so excited to share one of my first pieces in 2018 after coming back and deciding to reignite my passion for art. And so here I've really worked with something that's very familiar to me, which is on the drawing side, very comfortable to work with pen and ink and also with markers, which was a new set that I had gotten just to do this. So I'm excited to present this piece and all of its color, Beyond the Veil.
This is my painting Sunday, and as you can see, this is an encounter with the alchemical parrot dragon and the illustrious cat snail that generally frequent fairy rings of magical mushrooms. And so this is a depiction of a little magical encounter deep in the woods, and it is also a portrait of my pets, and I can tell you they really are this magical. So I painted with egg tempera and oils, just kind of utilizing the beautiful glow that you can get from the Miche technique to make it extra special, magical painting. So this is Sunday, and I'm glad to be a part of the Mushroom Painting Challenge.
Hello there! My name is Miranda Cromwell, and I am a multimedia visionary animal artist. I do predominantly animal subjects because I think that we can learn a lot from them, and it's a very healing thing for humanity to find empathy to other creatures, and the wolf especially, because it is so vilified. But I think that the wolf brings necessary balance to any of the ecosystems that they're reintroduced to. So I decided to pair the wolf spirit with the reishi mushroom. And the title of this piece is Reishi King. And for those that don't know, the reishi has really, really strong immune modulating and immune bolstering properties, and modern science is just kind of getting around to learning that. So the wolf and the reishi both have very powerful forces in nature, and I think that we can learn a lot from them and benefit from them. So that's the inspiration behind this piece. Thank you so much for having me. I can't wait to see all the other mushroom videos and the mushroom artwork in the group. What a great thing that we're doing. I'm very thankful to be here in the group, and I hope you guys like it. If you want to see more of my artwork, my website is marandart.com, marandart.com. And you'll see this guy up for sale and lots of other stuff in my gallery. And thank you so much. Have a good one.
Hi, I'm Brittany Monster, and this is my submission. It's called Rooting with Ancient Champions. And it's a story about me and a meditation that I had inside of a redwood tree in the old growth forest. Amazing. I was sitting, and I imagined I had roots, and I pushed my roots into the ground. And the tree took my roots, and it pushed both of our roots deeper, and it showed me how deep I could go. And the mycelium network was surrounding our roots together, And then it was firing off little messages to all the other mycelium in the forest to let everybody else know that I was there. And then it started to repair my DNA, and I could literally see it. So I wanted to try and show you that vision that I had. I've got the trillium in the forest here, and the DNA being repaired, and my root chakra, and the way this all came together was so amazing, because I would just hop on the vision train and the conversations would magically surround what problem I was facing in the painting. So you guys are incredible. The vision train is incredible, and bless the mycelium. So much love.
Hi, I'm Clive Hedger. This is my studio that you're finding me in now. And this painting is Sacrament. And this was painted specifically for the mushroom event that was part of Vision Train, of which I've been actively involved in over the last 3 months. I wasn't really sure what I was going to do for the mushroom event, and I've been thinking about it for a little while. And the event was happening just within a few hours, and literally 2 hours before the event, I had this clear vision that came to me. And like with much of my art, there was going to be religious symbols in it. So I found that Jesus and Buddha were there wanting to come and be part of this, and that the sacraments of the psilocybin mushroom and the Amanita muscaria, both of which grow in the lands here, were going to be on the altar. So this particular painting it has elements of traditional oil painting in the style of the kind of old masters, that kind of look, but with a modern edge. So particularly pleased with a lot of the elements of it, the way that the there's kind of two halves in it. I feel like the top of it is kind of psychedelic, and the bottom kind of feels very realistic and harks back to old ages. And the figures, these dancing or temple goddesses at the side, kind of not really sure whether they're temple goddesses or are they, you know, from a casino in Vegas. And I don't really know, you know, it was like this was the vision. Very pleased with this, and hopefully this will convey something of the sacredness of these beautiful teacher plants, the mushrooms that grow here, the psilocybin mushrooms that grow up on the hills around here in Wales. And so I hope you enjoy looking at this, and thank you very much.
Hi, Gypsy Visions here. I'm here to talk about my piece, Duality. I started this piece on the 4th of July, and I really wanted to go with something more abstract, a little bit more emotional, and just going by brushstrokes. I was very inspired by Vincent Van Gogh and his simplicity in brushstrokes. I really ran with that. Another big inspiration for this piece was psilocybin mushrooms. It really guided the path I wanted to take with this piece and gave me the direction I needed to see what was there. So here we have red and blue, which I find for myself represents the feminine and masculine energies battling each other and coming together. And then another inspiration of mine in this piece was the current state of our country. And I really wanted to depict that battle that we are riding out right now. So yes, it's basically the balance between all that is divine and the beauty coming back into our world, the light coming back into our world. Thank you.
Here's my mushroom painting. I've got this goo lady throwing down the mushrooms, spreading the seed. Regeneration, growth, nurturing, all from the conductors of the vision train, painters painting the light on the tracks, the DNA tracks being weaved by the spirit weavers, the creators, all working together with the mushroom forces. Yeah. Choo choo.
Are viewing Amanita's Warrior. Based on an Amanita seen on Larch Mountain in Washington on my birthday last year, as well as a hummingbird spotted in Costa Rica. And this painting was painted for my sister's 32nd birthday, which is coming up later this month on August 24th. So yeah, thank you for having me in the exhibition and I look forward to it.
This is Princess Mycelia. Her spirit is youthful, but her soul is ancient. She's having a pleasant conversation with her little Amanita friend, a fellow sage and magus in his own right. She spreads her wisdom through the spores that will populate the world. This is oil on canvas, and the halos are gold leaf. And my next offering is monk shroom. He is encircled by the Gayatri Mantra. And we have these little fellows here on the top of the mountain in deep meditation. He has a lotus halo and I have the chakras represented in somewhat of a subtle way. This is also oil on canvas and I use metallic gold to encircle the portal.
Happy mushroom painting, everybody. I am so grateful to share with you my piece. It's called Walk in the Forest. It's painted in acrylic and oil on canvas. And I have some mushrooms pictured here that are entering my life, and also some concepts that have come through from the painting process. So lion's mane, you can see oyster mushrooms, reishi mushrooms, porcelain mushrooms, and all around there's sort of these hints of psychedelic mushrooms, but I haven't painted any specifically. And there's also little chanterelles in there. So I really hope you enjoy looking at this piece. And I guess for me, the idea and the concept of land ownership has come up a lot, and I think there's a great need to restructure how we interact with the land and what we need to feel home and feel secure, because what it is something in our bodies that can exist and that has been stripped away from us if we've been through trauma. So I think walking in the forest is one of the most healing exercises we can do to connect with nature, to connect with ourselves, and hopefully we encounter some mushrooms along the way, because the mushrooms are these bodies of mycelium, and as artists we represent a mushroom, like a body of a network, a vast network of creatives, and through this I believe we can connect and we can unify and we can transfer resources, transfer wealth, transfer spiritual growth that we've gone through at an exponential rate when we do it together. So happy mushroom painting, happy just mushroom madness all around, and 15% of the proceeds of the sale of this painting will go to two organizations, both Black-led. One is the National Black Power and Land Fund, and the other one from the National Food Justice Alliance for Black Land. And the other is the Ochre Project, which is another food sovereignty project that feeds trans Black activists and basically people who just need food. So I really hope you can support, and let's continue this incredible community on the Vision Train. So blessings to everybody. Thank you.
Hey, I'm Olivia Jane Ari. Painting for me is my way of celebrating everything that inspires me and everything that I've learned on my journey so far. This piece called Mycelia is a celebration of not only the wonders of mycelium and the fungal kingdom, but also my friend Indy, who does a lot of work for food justice. So both celebrating her and celebrating this beautiful world that we live in.
Art is a relentless teacher. It shows me again and again the deep lessons of patience and humility. It challenges me to trust the process, be present, and exercise the diligent dedication that a creative practice demands. I often arrive to the studio, eager and naive, imagining that I will this time miraculously birth a new masterpiece with effortless expediency. But art is a persistent teacher. It reminds me that creativity is a journey, not a destination. There are many points in the process that it's tempting to put the painting aside and abandon it for some enticing blank canvas or rewarding near complete piece. Sometimes it's boring or just simply ugly. It takes incredible willpower to know that there are hundreds of hours of work remaining and to still sit down at the easel and continue on, one brushstroke at a time. It must be a joyful meditation, otherwise I could go mad from tedium. Art is a humbling teacher. This is not glamorous work. It is innumerable hours spent in isolation, in frumpy pajamas, working late into the night, back strained, eyes focused, caressing worlds out of nothingness. It demands my unwavering trust, my complete attention, and my deep surrender. It requires me to dedicate my body, mind, spirit, resources, and time, and then to unapologetically bear it to the world, my soul and nakedness, for all to see and judge. I cannot be discouraged by criticism, nor can I rely on approval. Art is a profound teacher. It continues to show me new depths of how to gracefully walk in the world. To be present with the process, get out of the way, choose where I put my attention, and do my best with the tools and skills I have in any moment. It teaches me the faith that every detail, no matter how trivial or unplanned, is part of an elaborate whole, and that someday I'll look back and it will all make sense. Art is also a loving teacher. When I trust the process and honor it with my attention and intention, it takes me to places I could never dream. It is my benevolent guide for the boundless potential of imagination. It is my muse who whispers me awake in the morning. It is my friend who rewards my loyalty with unfathomable blessings.